Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil mursaleen Sayyidina wa nabiyina wa maulana Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All praise, all thanks, all gratitude is towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, the cherisher, the sustainer of all the worlds. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His peace and His blessings on the most noble of prophets, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillahilladhi hadana lihada wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. All thanks and all praises due to Allah who has guided us to this, who has guided us to another blessed hour of Jumu'ah, who has guided us to this masjid collectively with our fellow believers to observe the holy waqt, the holy time of Jumu'ah, and has kept us intact from one Jumu'ah to the other. Had it not been for the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would surely not have been guided. وَنَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَنَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And we bear witness that there is no God, no deity, nothing else in this world that is worthy of being worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and we take no partners, and we share the sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with no one else except only to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we bear witness that our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amma ba'd, faya ibad Allah, O servants of Allah, ittaqullah, 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 rahimakumullah. Fear and obey only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that we may receive the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقَدْ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْكَرِيمِ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قُلْ إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. The servants of Allah who, when faced with setbacks, faced with challenges, faced with tragedies and faced with calamities, they say only, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Verily from Allah we come. We belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only, and to Allah is our return. We are on a journey constantly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everything between our origin and our destination is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are indeed in your hands. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-hadith, innamal a'malu binniyya. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us, every action is judged only by its intention. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks the truth, and so does our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My respected brothers and sisters, we live in a time of difficulty, a time of challenge, and for some, even a time of tragedy. As we watch the television, as we hear reports from Muslims all over this country, and indeed Muslims all over the world, and I come from the country of South Africa where people too are worried. Muslims in the Middle East who think that the dogs of war may now be opened again on some countries and so forth. This is indeed a time of fear, a time of portent, and maybe even a time of tragedy. As we see the appointments that are being made to government, we see that this fear is not an irrational fear, but it may indeed be having elements of rationality. That we may have a reason to wonder what will happen to all of us in this time that we are living in. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمْ خَسِبَتُمْ أَنْ تَدْخُلُوا bil jannah. Do you think, Allah says in the Quran, do you think that you will enter Jannah? The paradise, the gardens of bliss, without tests and trials, coming to you as it has come to those before you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that no generation of Muslims is ever unique in the tests and trials that they must endure. Those before you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, encountered suffering and adversity and were so shaken. And Allah uses the word zilzal, which is the same that Allah uses for the final day. Idha zulzilatil ardu fil zalaha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those before you were so shaken that even the early Muslims under the leadership of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that even the Prophet and those believers with him in Makkah, they cried to the heavens, Mata Nasrullah, when will the help of Allah come? And Allah says in that same verse, Allah inna Nasrullah il Qareeb, verily the help of Allah is always near. That is the assurance in a time of fear that we have from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah's help is always near and that we are only going through a trial and a test, terrible as it may be and terrible as it could be. We must understand that it is not unique to us, not in this country, because I come from a country, South Africa, where Islam has been established for 350 years. The early Muslims came there as slaves. Islam was banned for a century. Those even caught making salah was open to either imprisonment, the loss of their property, or even the loss of their lives. Today, alhamdulillah, we have endured that, and we are of the most integrated, comfortable Muslim communities that is on the face of the earth in today's time. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says to us in the Holy Quran, when Allah says, it is not righteousness, lays al-bir, it is not simply righteousness that you turn your face to the east and the west only in salah, calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the search for Allah. But it is righteousness, and the things we know is that we believe in Allah, that we believe in the last day, that we believe in the angels, that we believe in the divine revelation, the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all the messengers. It is also righteousness that we do good on this earth, that we spend of our substance to anyone who deserves it. And Allah says, and to be steadfast in prayer, to practice regular charity, to fulfill our contracts when we have entered into contracts, to be firm and patient in pain, suffering, and adversity, and throughout all periods of panic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to be firm and steadfast, to be resilient. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and such are the people who always stand on truth, and such are the people who fear only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, my respected brothers and sisters, in this time that we're living in, when we look at those who have gone before us, in the heart of the 2-year boycott of the early Muslims, when Muslims were not allowed to marry into Quraysh, when Quraysh stopped people from selling food and clothes to Muslims, in the time when Sayyidina Bilal was tortured, may Allah be pleased with him. Sumayyah, may Allah be pleased with her, was martyred. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was humiliated. In these times, it was very instructive that it was men of Quraysh, not believers, but idolaters, men of Quraysh, particularly led by Hisham and Zuhair, who decided that what was being done to the Muslims was inhuman. And they decided to oppose the decree that Abu Jahl, and listen to the name Abu Jahl, the father of ignorance. And we wonder whether there isn't Abu Jahls in the world that we're living in today to oppose the imposition of this ban on the Muslims. And they said, we cannot be onlookers while some are being forced to perish. Zuhair stood up in the haram and he said, people of Mecca, are we to eat food and to wear clothes while the sons of Hashim perish? By God, I will not rest until this unjust ban is torn up. Abu Jahl stood up to oppose him, but they found that many amongst the Quraysh, whether they believed or not, whether they followed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or not, whether they worshipped idols or not, they stood up and stood for humanity, and so Abu Jahl's 2-year boycott was broken. And so what we need to understand from that time is that we have not only precedents, not only things going before us of suffering, but we also have from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the acceptance of protection and help from even the ideology that Islam came to oppose, based on a simple recognition of each other's humanity. That where there was sympathy, even from amongst the mushrikeen, it was welcomed in order to break an impossible period of suffering for the early Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself was faced with this, and so was Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr, once he had become Muslim, he lost his wealth and he lost his influence. And so he was humiliated and beaten up and was left to die, but survived it. And then decided that he was going to join the Muslims who had gone to Abyssinia. And on his way there, he met another person who did not believe like him, but who understood that Abu Bakr was essentially a man of honor. And this man went and said to Quraysh, this man Abu Bakr is now under my protection. Because he couldn't understand why they did this to Abu Bakr. May Allah be pleased with him. Because he says to Abu Bakr, he said to him, how could they have done this to you? You are an ornament to your clan, a help in misfortune, a doer of what is right, always fulfilling the needs of others. Return, for you are now under my protection. Is that not what the situation of American Muslims are? That we are a help, that we are people of right, that we ought to be an adornment in a multicultural society. And there are enough people who recognize that. At least 50% of those who voted recognize that this is the case. And so the question is, do we want to become exclusive victims? Because we are not the only victims of the Abu Jahls of today or the Abu Lahabs of today. There are others who have suffered all the time, like African American youth who are shot in the streets, like Hispanics who are also being spat at today, like women who are being abused verbally and physically. And so there is no, as we have seen from the early history, there is no honor in suffering alone, in rejecting help. And so sometimes we have these arguments about whether those who are in the Jewish community should be giving us help and should we be accepting it because of what they do. If they too feel threatened by this current order, We may not agree with them in the long term, but is that not some of the things that we should be considering, even if it is for the immediate period of danger? The Christian priests who stand up, the Black Lives Matter who protest, the Hispanic leaders who speak out, the school children in Seattle who have gone on demonstrations. These really are the very important things that we need to do, because the Prophet ﷺ also taught us the example of the Hilful Fudul, the coalition or the alliance for virtue. When before Nubuwa, he went to the house of Ibn Jud'an when a Yemeni merchant was the victim of injustice and called for help, and the clans of Makkah came together and they made a resolution that day that no one will suffer injustice, and they called it the Hilful Fudul, the coalition for virtue. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, many years later, while he was a Nabi now, he said, I was present at this coalition, and if today in Islam I were asked to do so again, I would gladly respond. How do we reach out to others who suffer with us or who sympathize with us? Some are with us all the way, some are with us some of the way, and some are only with us for the beginning. But this is the time when Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab is around with us and are drawing up registers, immigration plans, considering internment camps, humiliating our women, and all of those kind of things. And so we need to not every one of us think on our own, how do we survive this, but to reach out rather than retreat in. Because as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is not righteousness that you only go to the mosque and you make salam in your salahs and so forth. But it is righteousness that you be resilient. You remain on truth. You reach out to others. You stand for what is right. And more importantly, in the one verse that I had recited to you, those who are on that path, Allah says, you also maintain the contracts into which you have entered. In South Africa, we never gave up on our contract of citizenship. We understood that we were citizens of South Africa for decades and for centuries. And that part of fulfilling our contract of citizenship was to say what was true, what was just, what was right, what are the rights of us and what are the rights of others. And so fulfilling our contracts also is the contract of citizenship that we have entered into. And so inshallah we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must strengthen us with hidayah, with Allah's guidance in this moment, and not our own anger or our own fear. If we have too much fear, we will become passive and retreat. If we have too much anger, we may become extreme and do wrong things and endanger everyone. We need to find the wasatiya. We need to become the ummatan wasatan, the ummah that remains in the middle, standing firm on truth but not being reckless. Neither passive nor extreme. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to that middle path, inshallah. والآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر الصديق وعمر بن الخطاب وعثمان بن عفان وعلي بن أبي طالب رضي الله وكرم الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. My respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us in the Quran لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah does not place a burden on any soul greater than it can bear. That is our comfort. Whatever the burdens and the tragedies and the losses and the grief we face, it is within our capacity as Muslims to bear it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says that every good we get, it's because we deserve it. And every difficulty we get, we must evaluate whether we have done enough. And so, on day like this, we also pray to Allah not to make us burdened with things which we cannot bear. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal muslimin. Wa dhilla shirka wal mushrikin. Allahumma ansur man nasra din Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma malikul mulk. تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربي أسر ولا تؤسر ربي أسر ولا تؤسر ربي أسر ولا تؤسر. Oh Allah, make it easy and don't make it difficult for us. ربي تمم بالخير, make it emerge with something that is good and better. ربنا زدنا علما وارزقنا فهما. Oh Allah, give us knowledge in this time, but also the inspiration and the insight into that knowledge as we go forward, inshallah. Rabbana wa la tuhammilna ma la taqatlana bih wa'fu anna waghfir lana warhamna anta khayrul rahimin. Barakallahu lana bil ayati wa dhikril hakim fataqabbala minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu wal ghafurur rahim.